Hello, welcome, and thanks for joining us live on Progen Media TV, wherever you are and where you're tuning in from. We are very grateful, but kindly consider subscribing and turning on the notification button for more of these updates. His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni reveals what he will do to the bankruptcy Russian company awarded GEC Digital Monitors contract. Once again, thanks for joining us live on Progen Media TV. But let's take more look into some of these details. President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni Tibuhaburwa government has spoken out on what will happen next to Russian firm joint stock company Global Security Systems after it emerged that it was facing bankruptcy litigations back home. And last week, the Russian firm inked a deal with Uganda's Security, Works and Transport Ministries. And according to the permanent secretaries, there is Waiswa Baligeya of the Works and Transport Ministry and Yunus Kakande of the Office of the President, an inter-ministerial committee approved the deal. So the permanent secretaries also claimed they had discussed the award of this contract for months. And last Friday, the PS Baligeya and Kakande signed the 10-year contract on behalf of the Ugandans. Ivan Sukraban, the chief executive officer of the joint stock Global Security Systems, signed for the Russian firm. CEO Yoweri Sukraban and his company committed to recover their investment in 2 years before handing over the project to the government. Security Minister Yoweri Major General Jim Muhwezi emphasized that vehicle owners will pay for the purchase and the installations of the digital monitors, and the trackers will be mandatory, and government hopes they will help in the hunting down of the criminals. Minister Muhwezi dared anyone who has dissatisfied with the project on grounds of invasion of privacy to go to court and sue him. And perennial litigant Hassan Mel Mabiris has already done that by suing them. And the joint stock Global Security Systems faces a myriad of bankruptcy and debt cases back in Russian courts of law. So in March 2019, the Russian prompt technology sued joint stock company Global Security Systems after it defaulted on its 16.6 million rubles, that is roughly $220,000, and court ruled that joint stock company Global Security Systems had indeed failed to pay this Russian prompt technology company. So over a year later, in September, that is 2020, Russia Prom Technologies dragged joint company Global Security Systems to the arbitration court of the city of Moscow and over bankruptcy. And Russian Prom Technologies asked court to declare joint stock company Global Security Systems bankrupt, an application whose hearing was sanctioned the following month, but the determination of the matter has stalled. Joint stock company Global Security Systems asking that the determination of the matter be deferred as it bought time to pay off the debt. Months later, in March, that is 2021, court tasked joint stock company Global Security Systems to table evidence of debt clearance when a court next convenes to hear the case in September 2021. And also more cases have been coming. And the stock trading LLC sued joint stock company Global Security Systems over 1.2 million rubles debt. And also JSC Royal Silk Factory sued joint stock company Global Security Systems over 19.9 million rubles debt. And not only that, more cases kept on coming about the joint stock company that is going to deal with Ugandans in installing the security cameras in every Ugandan's vehicles. So today, GSA Slovak Republic sued also joint stock company Global Security Systems over 6.1 million rubles debt, and also JSCV sued joint stock company Global Security Systems over three debts, that is 23 million rubles, 10 million rubles and 4.6 million rubles. Limited liability partnership, Oken Alem sued joint stock company Global Security Systems over an 8.5 million ruble debt. And GU main department of the pension fund of the Russian Federation should also joint stock company Global Security Systems over two debts, that is 10,000 rubles and 455,000 rubles. So questions have been going on because of this joint stock company that is facing some allegations or some court suings due to the bankruptcy it's causing. So the questions are going on the revelations of joint stock company Global Security Systems and bankruptcy have raised a number of questions. Who recommended the firm to Museveni? People are asking themselves number of questions that who recommended the firm to Museveni, and is this the best security company government could find? Who were the other bidders? So where procurement laws followed? Was joint stock company Global Security Systems looking for a third world country that doesn't take procurement laws seriously for its financial resuscitations? Those are the questions going on. And other questions are, what was the role of the Financial Intelligence Authority in the awarding of the contract? And who did the inter-ministerial committee that picked the firm consult? Who was that person? And some Museveni's governance response towards this, according to the available media reports, officials at both the Office of the President and the Ministries of Works and Transport and Security did not know about the Russian company's financial standings. And President Museveni's government, that is Attorney General Chiro Wachiwanuka, has been quoted as saying he gave his approval to the contract. And he said the contract was brought direct to his office. He approved it. They approved it and they believe there is no risk. And Uganda is not exposed to anything at all. So that was Attorney General Chiro Wachiwanuka that told local news agents on one of the radio networks in Uganda. And contract was approved by his office, as he continued saying, and taking into consideration all the laws of this country, and we ascertain that we don't have any order of bankruptcy issued against the company. So for now, the Attorney General's remains President Museveni's and his government's positions on the matter. However, it is not clear if Museveni, under whose office of the security ministry runs, will cancel the contract if there is sufficient evidence that joint stock company Global Security System is indeed bankrupt. If the president goes ahead and allows the Russian company to execute the contract, he will have floated procurement laws that bar bankrupt companies to get contracts since they lack the financial capacity to implement them. Well, that is it for now. Thanks for watching Projan Media TV. But we'll keep on updating with more of this. Kindly do one thing. Subscribe and turn on the notification button. All these updates will come to you in time.